नमस्ते, वेलकम सिक्स्थ क्लास स्टूडेंट्स। पार्ट 3। सो सिक्स्थ क्लास, इन द लास्ट लेसन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द सेकंड लेसन अप टू सम पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक्स। Second lesson. Globe. Model of the Earth. Model of the Earth. So here, in the last class, we have discussed about the shape of the Earth. And how the shape, the original shape of the Earth, and why the globe is not exposing the original shape of the Earth, and what are the things we can know about from seeing and from observing the globe. So after that, next we are going to discuss. In the last class we have discussed these also, the landforms, the surface of the Earth is divided into two parts, land and water. So in this land and water also there are some particular divisions, like land is divided into some continents and water is divided into some oceans. Not only this, water is also having a particular form on the land also. So in this way the earth surface is divided into two parts, land and water. So there are seven continents as we discussed. There are seven continents and there are four oceans. Actually there are five oceans are there, but one is frozen. That's why we are discussing the water, means the flowing part of the water. But the water can't stay at one place. It can't be in a stable way. So that's why the flowing part is having for only four oceans. There are the four oceans. So seven continents and four oceans and one is frozen ocean. So along with all these, the earth is divided into these two parts. And what are the seven continents? Seven continents are Asia, Africa, South America, North America, as we discussed in the last class. In the same way, oceans are Pacific Ocean, Atlantic, Indian, Antarctica. So these are the oceans we discussed in the last class. So here, among all these oceans, all these continents coming to the shape of the Earth. So as a shape of the Earth is like this, the continents are in different forms. Europe here, Asia, Africa, Australia, North America, South America, Arctic, Antarctic. So these are the continents 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, sorry, 1, So these are the seven continents. These seven continents are located on the Earth in different shapes and different landforms. So in between these, water is flowing in the form of oceans. So as we discussed in the last classes, rotation and revolution. The Earth rotates itself around the Sun for 1 year. It will take 1 year. So these rotation, one rotation takes 24 hours, one revolution takes 365, 1/4 day. So in this way, the earth is completing its revolution and rotation. As we are discussing that the earth rises from the east and sets in the west. Actually, sun won't move from its stabled place. Actually, the earth is moving around the sun in the form of rotations, in the form of revolutions, on its own path called orbit. Here the earth is revolving around the sun in the process of revolution only. We are thinking that the sun is moving around the sun, around the earth, but actually sun is staying at the same place, but earth is revolving around the sun. So that's why the earth is starting its rotation from east to west. That's why we are seeing the sunrise in the east and the sunsets in the west, and going to the back, it is getting night from west to east again. It is moving light again. That's why in the east again we are getting the sunrise. So it is rotating one circle. That's why one half is getting the sun rays and other half is getting the night darkness. So the earth is starting moving from the east like this to the west. That's why we are thinking that sun rises in the east and the west, and again it is starting one more half from west to east. So in this way it is completing its revolution and rotation around the sun. So many children will get a doubt, that is, the earth is moving around the sun, but why the people who are living on the earth, the water which is present on the earth, the things which are present on the earth, not falling down? Why the people and why the water which is present on the earth surface is not falling down? Why? What is the reason? So because the earth is completing its rotation and revolution from years to years, from millions of years from till now, but no one is falling down into the universe. Why? What is the reason? Here we all know the magnetic power. I think you have already, or you are going to discuss in your social science subject, that what is magnetic power. Magnetic power means it will attract each other, and it will catch each other very tightly. So this is called as magnetic power, which won't leave each other. This one won't leave this one, and this one won't leave this one. It is having the power of magnet. It is catching like this. So in the same way, on the earth surface there is a magnetic power which is catching everything which is on the surface. That's why the things won't fall into the universe. That means fall down. The complete rounds of the earth, according to the shape of the earth, on the earth there is so many people, so many living things, so many vehicles, so many things which are present on the earth surface are not falling down because of the power of the magnetic power which is present on the earth terrain, and it which is catching the things and human world on the earth surface. It is also called as gravitational force. That's why due to this force and power, no one will fall into the universe or fall down. So this is the reason for the catching of the earth terrain. Terrain means surface, upper layer of the earth. So next, so here we will discuss that what are the continents which are on the continents and oceans which are on the earth. So we can observe some lines present on the globe, but not originally on the earth lines. There are two lines present on the globe. First one is latitudes, second one is longitudes. Latitudes and longitudes. So before going to the latitudes and longitudes, what are the lines present on the globe? This is the globe. There are some lines we can see on the globe. There are two set of lines present on the globe. One is from west to east, another one is from north pole to south pole. So firstly, these lines are imaginary lines. These lines are imaginary lines, but these lines are not present on the earth. These lines are the imaginary lines which are drawn on the globe only. Globe or map. These are the imaginary lines. To these two set of lines are drawn on the globe. Why did the map inventors or map makers drawn these lines on the earth or globe means? The reason is by these latitudes and longitudes, by seeing and observing these latitudes and longitudes, we can identify the time and the place on the globe itself. These lines make very easy to us to identify or point out the place or a time of a place. It will make very easy. So these are the imaginary lines. These two set of lines are the imaginary lines. These are not there on the earth, they are drawn on the globe itself only. The map makers and inventors invented these two set of lines to identify the place, where the place is and what is the time of the place. So that's why, due to these two reasons, these lines are drawn on the globe. So by calculating according to the latitudes and longitudes, we can say where is that place. We can say the direction of that place. We can say the time of that place. Okay. So these latitudes and longitudes are the set of two lines, and which are the imaginary lines. The two set of lines which are passing each other. One is from top to bottom and another one is from west side to east side. So these lines are passing each other. Then there is a model of checks, boxes like this. We can see the boxes on the lines are passing each other means we can see the chucks, that means boxes on the globe. So these type is called as grid. This is called as grid, which is called as boxes. This is the boxes which we can see by the two set of lines. This is called as grid. This is called as grid. So nextly, so first we will discuss about the latitudes. Latitudes means, the definition of the latitude is an imaginary lines, and imaginary lines which are passing from west to east are called as latitudes. Are called as, like these lines are drawn from west to east, so these are called as latitudes. Like this. So firstly, we have to point out the directions on the globe or a map. So for a map or a globe, so the directions are, the top of the thing is north. We can say it has, on the globe or earth, it is north pole. The bottom, the down part, is called as south, and we can call it as a south pole. And our left hand side and the right hand side, these two hands, left hand side and the right hand side, so these is called as west. And right hand side is called as east. This is east. So these are the directions for the maps. Whether it is any map or any globe, we have to decide these directions on it. North, top, bottom, south, left hand side, west, right hand side, east. So these are the directions. After that, latitudes, coming into the latitudes, according to the size, shape of the earth, here, the shape, according to the shape of the earth, here it is broad, and going on up or going on down, it is coming on, getting very thin, it is decreasing its size, like this, it is, by this point, it is the, from the latitude, from the middle of the globe to the north pole, it decreased its shape. It is decreased. So that's why, due to the shape of the earth, so the decreasing from middle to the north or south pole, all the latitudes are not equal. Because of that, latitudes are not equal. All the latitudes are not equal due to the shape of the earth. So the latitude which is passing from west to east in the middle of the earth is called as equator. And it is also 0 degrees. It is also called as 0 degree latitude. Equator. The middle of the latitude which is present in the middle of the earth is called as 0 degree latitude, and it is called as equator. So after that, going to the north side, here, these are the main latitudes. This is 23.5 degrees north. It is Tropic of Cancer. Tropic of Cancer, 23 end of degrees N. After that, 66 end of degrees N, it is called as Arctic Circle. Arctic Circle, these are the important latitudes. Coming to here, North Pole, this is 90 degrees N. 90 degrees N. In the same way, coming to the South. So, the here, 23 end of degrees S, which is called as Tropic of Capricorn. Capricorn. Tropic of Capricorn, 23 end of degrees S. In the same way, 66 end of degrees S, South. It's called as Antarctic Circle. Antarctic Circle. Antarctic Circle. And here, South Pole, 90 degrees S. This is South Pole. So these are the important latitudes. These are the important latitudes. So 0 degrees latitude is called as equator. 23 end of degrees N, Tropic of Cancer. 66 end of degrees N, Arctic Circle. 90 degrees N, North Pole. Again, 23 end of degrees S, Tropic of Capricorn. 66 end of degrees S, Antarctic Circle. 90 degrees S is called as South Pole. So these are the main latitudes, and according to the shape of the earth, all the latitudes are not equal. One more important thing is, this is the earth globe, north, south, west and east. So this is the equator, 0 degrees latitude also we can say. This one, the 0 degrees latitude, which is called as equator, divides the earth into two parts, two equal parts or two equal halves. 0 degrees latitude. So these 0 degrees latitude is called as equator, which dividing the earth into two equal parts. So these halves are called, actually shape of the earth is sphere. Half sphere is called as hemisphere. So that's why this is northern hemisphere. We can also say northern hemisphere also we can say. Northern hemisphere, and it is south part, no, that's why southern hemisphere. Southern hemisphere. Okay? Equator divides the earth into two equal halves, which are called as hemispheres. Hemisphere means half part, half sphere is called as. So this is the north part, that's why northern hemisphere. This is south part, that's why southern hemisphere. And this is the equator. These are the directions. So until here we completed the latitudes, longitudes and their specialties, and the divisions of the land according to the latitudes and longitudes we will discuss in the next class. So part 3, 6th class students, we have completed our part 3 up to here. Note the important points, attempt the exam very well. All the best and thank you.